Lions Club is the largest NGO in the world. I'm B Mechanical, MA in Economics and Political Sciences, 18 years of industry experience. I do research in ancient wisdom and then apply the ancient wisdom to modern problems. I do corporate training, life coaching, outbound training, seminars, and also speaker at the Help Library. This is corporate training. This is outbound training. Ashish building. Business owner training. Personality development seminars. I also have a drama based on distance palmistry. Savadh raha tumcha haat boltoy. Where we show in 2.5 hours how you can understand a person's nature by looking at his hand from a distance of 10 to 15 feet. I keep appearing on the TV for face reading, body language and related subjects. And videos on the net, if you check for my videos, these are on face reading, Vastu Shastra, distance palmistry, sensitive points therapy, body language. So thank you to Help Library, you all and myself, because all three of us are making this thing possible. So today what we are going to see is Yin and Yang. This is a book that I have written, or I am writing, on Yin Yang. Yin Yang is a Chinese concept. Most of us know the concept in general. Yin means the dark part, Yang means the light part. Yin means the night, Yang means the day. Yang means the activity, Yin means the passive part. And these both, when they are balanced, we have got good health, wealth, prosperity, etc. When they are not balanced, then we have problem. But the beauty of this concept or beauty of this is that it can be taken to much deeper levels by just studying it. And it can be used in multiple ways. You can use it for good health, you can use it for how you can be, for your well-being, you can use it for your studies, you can use it for your work. The application of the concept is everywhere. So what is Yin and what is Yang? So this black part you see is the Yin and the white part you see is the Yang. At the same time you will see that Yin has a small part of Yang and Yang has a small part of Yin, and then that curved line shows that it keeps on going from one to another. So the Yin keeps on going to Yang, Yang keeps on going to becoming Yin. So that it is a continuous process, it is one in the other, the transformation is continuous.
Whiteness and blackness also change.
Also change. The complete wheel moves. It's like day becoming night, night becoming day. The wheel keeps on turning. The wheel keeps on turning. Okay. For example, what we see here is a tree. What we see is Yang and what we don't see is Yin. If the tree, this is the only tree which is standing in such a big desert, it must have a huge amount of supporting system, which is the roots. The roots must be much bigger than this, but the roots we don't see. Roots are getting its nutrition. There does not seem to be any water around. But the tree is green because the roots are getting the water from the deep down the earth. So this root and the support system is Yin, and what we see, the action part, is Yang. In this case, what we see is the electricity which is created, or the lightning, thunder. The thunder is Yang. And how the thunder is created is because of the electric charge which is in the clouds. That charge goes on increasing and increasing, and at one point it discharges. So that is the time we see it. Till then we don't see it, we don't feel it. So that is that Yin transforming into Yang. Yin becomes Yang. So in short, what is Yang is what is seen, felt or done. Any activity we do is Yang. Anything that we see is Yang. Anything that we feel is Yang. Yin is not seen nor felt. It is latent. or hidden, and it is waiting. For example, exercise is yang, but sleep is exactly reverse of exercise. Sleep is yin. Food is yang. Habits are yin, because habits, we don't feel that we are having habits unless somebody points out. They become our second nature. Yes? Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Namaskar. Artha suru kela. Heritage is yin. So many students from India, they go abroad and they do well. They feel that they are the ones who are smart. No, they are not smart, because they have got an Indian heritage which shows, which tells them about hard work, etc., etc., the culture. Going to that place, their yang is much better, because their yin was much higher. Then history is yin. Coal is yin, because coal doesn't show off energy unless we burn it. Yeah. Gas is also yin, petrol is yin, car is yang. The yang moves because there is a yin. Car does not move without petrol.
In short, if we say there, if there is a potential,
yes, yin, potential is yin.
Effect is
transformation of potential into action is yang. Yes. Why recognizing yin and yang is so important? Is then once we start recognizing that, we can apply it in different areas. Otherwise, there will be problem in recognizing itself. Yes.
This transformation is also, it can be transforming into.
It is. All the time it is transforming. And yang is transforming into yin. Yin is transforming into yang. In the sense, for example, if I get up in the morning, every 5 o'clock in the morning, today only, then it is yang.
Yeah.
But if I get up 5 o'clock in the morning tomorrow, day after, 7 days, 8 days, 10 days, then it becomes a habit, it becomes yin. So after 10 to 15 days, okay, I will get up at 5 o'clock without the alarm, that time that yang has already transformed into a yin. Okay. In the second day also, second other side also, a person who doesn't smoke, in the college, his friends tell him, you start smoking. Smoking, because it is action, it is yang. So first time he smokes, he stutters, he gets that smoke in his nose and stuff like that, he feels uncomfortable. Twice, thrice, four times, five times he does it, then he gets used to it. Then a time comes when without smoking, he feels uncomfortable. If he is not smoking, that time smoking has become yin.
Acha. Then that yin,
yeah,
smoking will give you body energy.
Yes.
Because it is habituated.
It is habituated. Same way about tea. You don't have tea in the morning, you are going to feel uncomfortable, because tea has become Indian drink and tea has become yin part of our diet. So you will see that unless the doctor tells you to count the number of tea cups that you have in the every day, we do not know. Our count is generally like between 15 to 20. But we don't even notice it, because it is coming from the yin part. If we were to take, say, the coconut juice, then we might have only 2 or 3. We might not have more than that, because it will have the yang part of going to that coconut vendor, getting that coconut cut, then drinking the coconut water. So there is a lot of activity involved. But in case of tea, everything is ready. Or tea is ready everywhere. So we might drink tea, thoda sa tumhare saath, thoda sa iske saath, thoda sa aur kisi ke saath, 15, 20 cups. Yeah, right, right. Okay.
This happens in case of tea.
Okay, fine. Now, let us go to organs. This is the part that we are starting new this time. There are yang organs and there are yin organs. So what you have here is all these organs are yin organs. Like lung, heart, spleen, liver, and kidneys. These are all yin organs. These are the organs which are involuntary. Involuntary organs are called as yin organs. They go on working without you knowing it. Unless there is a problem, you will not know it. And the yang organs are the organs which are to some extent involuntary, but to large extent they are voluntary. The large intestine, the small intestine, the stomach, the gallbladder and the bladder, out of which the gallbladder is yang to some extent. I'll tell you how. It is different way. I'll tell you how. But in this case, these are all completely involuntary.
Brain meridian, not there.
Pardon?
Brain meridian.
No, it is not here. It is in the next part, much later. Yeah, I think it will be in the fourth part of this lecture. Because see, this concept is so powerful that unless we understand it part by part, it becomes very difficult, very confusing. So we have to understand it part by. Yeah. Now you will see that, for example, if you eat something and you have got stomach ache, where is it is coming from? Either it is coming from large intestine, small intestine, or stomach. It might come within minutes or within hours, not more than 3 hours. Even food poisoning cannot happen after 3 hours. In 3 hours, the food is digested. So you will see that these organs react quickly because it is yang. They take action quickly. Okay? Whereas, and the gallbladder also, for that matter, gallbladder, what the gallbladder is doing, it is responsible for digesting or giving digestive juices, bile and all, to the stomach. So the moment you will see, for example, you see some ripe lemons, you will start feeling that your mouth is watering.
Yeah.
At the same time, stomach juices are coming out. So in that sense, it is voluntary.
Okay.
If you are hungry, immediately the acid, stomach acids will start coming out.
Secreting juices.
Secreting juices.
It responds to external stimuli.
It responds to external stimuli immediately.
Immediately.
So immediate is one of the criteria of yang. Immediate action. So in that sense, it comes here. In case of bladder also, bladder is only a bag which is keeping urine and stuff like that, and it is also reacting immediately. Whereas in this case, you will see that all these organs don't complain for almost a lifetime. And when they start complaining, it is a lifetime complaint. Both ways. Heart will go on and on and on till one day it says, nahi. That kind of thing. So here, it absorbs a lot of the jerks, lot of the problems, lot of the discomfort without saying anything. And then it goes on becoming weaker and weaker, and the effect, we can see it there. So the effect is there, the potential is here. In fact, you will be surprised that many people amongst us, they live on just 1/4 of the lung capacity.
Yeah.
Because we don't have to do much hard work. So that lung, even if it is down by almost 70% or even 80%, the person is not going to feel much discomfort. Same thing about heart,
yes.
Same thing about spleen, same thing about liver, same thing about kidneys. Unless we are on the last leg, we will not realize. Now we will see that the foods that we eat for these are yin, foods that we eat for those are yang. So if you want to improve the yin organ, you should be eating yin food. You want to increase yang organ, you should be eating yang food. Of course, some area from this, some yang from this is going to become yin. And some yin from here is going to become yang, because it is not completely separate. Yeah? So let's see that also. Yeah. So now, what is the balance point and what are the yang organs, yang foods, and what are the yin foods? So what are the yang foods is fish, poultry, cheese, red meat, eggs, salt. These are all yang. So the people who are doing a lot of action, activity oriented, people who are doing physical action, they should be having more of yang food.
This side is more of protein.
Yang, proteins. But you would call it yang, because proteins is a part of physical part. Yang is energy. So the problem is, you will see here also, the fruits are there. They are also protein. Then what is the difference in those proteins and these proteins? The difference between the two is that these proteins are giving yang energy, action energy, whereas those are making your health better from the inside. They are increasing your potential, but they are not giving a outside effect. Okay? Like, and of course, at the same time, it should be eaten in balance. Like you will say, sugar is there. in that part. But sugar is yin in nature, its energy is yin. Because when you eat sugar, the energy is immediately released and energy is going to the lungs, the heart and so on and so forth. But if you eat too much of sugar, then it is going to be stored as fat somewhere, it is going to have some other problems, it is going to go out of the system, etc., etc. So here, and any of these, if it is not cooked. So what you see red meat here or fish here is all uncooked. Okay, the more uncooked the food, the more energy it will have. Okay. When you are heating in anything, the oil is coming out, you are boiling it, then the energy is going into that water. It is easier to digest. Yes. See, one of our main problems here is that because we have started cooking, that's why we are fattening. Because if you were to eat raw food, you will have so much of raw food, and you will take the whole day to digest it. Your stomach will not be able to push it forward because it is still undigested. Whereas you cook it, means what you do is you are doing half the digestion in outside. Then you are eating the food. So it is easily digested and then pushed forward. So we are getting calories much faster than we would do otherwise.
What about the energy? Is it energy decreased by cooking?
Energy is decreased, but then your quantity is increased. See, for example, if it was uncooked, you might have maybe 100 grams. That will be it for the whole day. When it is cooked, you have 500 grams. Maybe out of those 500 grams, only 300 grams will be digested. But it is still three times what it was before. So you are getting much more energy than what you require. Okay. In fact, that is why salads and all are called as negative energy diets, because they consume more energy in digesting than they can give to your body.
Okay, that is why it is thinning.
Yes, because when you eat a lot of salad, to digest it, some fat or some muscle from your body has to work overtime. And when it works overtime, it is consuming energy from the body, and when it is consuming energy from the body, the body is likely to thin out. So these, all of these are yin and all of these are yang. And these yin things have to be taken in very small supply. You have to be very careful when taking yin foods, because yin foods are habit forming. Yin foods are full of energy, like that sugar, coffee, etc., etc. And yin foods are energy giving. So either you use that energy or you don't take it.
More of a carbohydrates.
Not necessarily. That classification is not here. Carbohydrates is whole grains is carbohydrates. This the cheese is carbohydrate and protein. So that carbohydrate and that division is not made here. It is dependent on the energy, the type of energy it gives. So you will see that those people who are doing a lot of yin, like the Buddhist monks, they will have food on that side. They are meditating. So they need calmness, coolness, constant sitting at one place. That's all they need to do. So when you are eating foods on that side, your energy is going to be cool energy, relaxed energy. Yeah, where you are going to have this, you got to be doing a lot of hard work. Okay, if you are now, what happens is, if you are doing a lot of hard work and you are having food from there is unbalance. If you are just sitting around and having food from this side, there is still unbalance. And Chinese method says that whenever there is balance, there is health. When there is imbalance, there is disease. So if you want to have balance, you need to check up how much kind of yang work I do and how much of yang food I eat, based on your lifestyle. Like for example, children, you start giving that yin food, the child is going to sit in front of TV all the time, because he is not going to have energy to go out and play. He has got energy to meditate, but he doesn't have the age to meditate. He doesn't have that peace of mind to meditate. So what is going to happen? He is going to feel like sitting where? Sitting in front of the TV. So now you can see why it so starts happening that we have got obesity and all the other problems which are in greater amount. Another thing that you have on this side is there is a huge amount of energy. Okay, and that much huge amount of energy you should be in a position to digest. Like a sugar, for example, one spoonful of sugar, that to get that much sugar in the body, you might have to eat 3 or 4 fish. Then it will get converted, and after 3 hours or 4 hours, you are going to get one spoonful of sugar. There, you just go to the dabba, dip into it, take one spoonful, eat it. Okay, whole process of making sugar has been done outside. The sugar cane has been crushed, the juice has been taken out, the juice has been dried, the juice has been cleaned up of all the minerals and other things, and you get a white sugar. So just to get white sugar, if you are to be on this side, young food, you would be having a sugar cane at least 3 feet, 2 feet long, minimum 2 feet. And then when you eat that and digest it, after 3 or 4 hours, you are going to get one spoonful of sugar, which you directly get from the packet of sugar. So now you see that where the imbalance occurs in the food habits. Okay. Now this is another interesting part. Yin is called as earth energy. And yang is called as sky energy. Sky we are able to see, below the earth we are not able to see. So it is another way of making the concept simpler. Yin comes from mother, inherited. Yang comes from father. In the sense, we do some action and then get it. And you will see that it is slightly, then you can go to the Taiji pole and then you can come to this year. The 5 yin organs are given here and the 5 yang organs are given here. Okay? So this energy is going to the, what you are talking about, the brain meridian and all, that comes in this part that we are not going to take today. We'll be taking in the next lecture, because this is the area that we need to really think about. And using yin and yang conundrum, we should be looking at our activity, our food habits, our health, our diseases, our problems. In everywhere, you should be able to see the yin. Is this yin? We have to ask this question again and again. Am I doing yin and am I eating yang? That kind of thing. When we are doing that exercise again and again, our knowledge will become deeper and deeper. Yeah. And when it becomes deeper, for example, there is an example of a doctor. There is an example of a CEO, big CEO, 42 years of age. He was in pink of health. He was every day going to gym. He was running about 10 kilometers every day. And one day, at the age of 42, he just had a heart attack and he died. So then they were looking for reasons why it could happen. I think his name was Asim Das or something. I don't remember the name. Yes. And what they found out was all that he was doing right. He was eating right food. He was doing the right exercise. He was taking the right medicines. But only thing he was cutting on was sleep. He was sleeping only 3 to 4 hours a day. Yes. What is sleep? Sleep is yin. And what sleep is doing? Sleep is building up the muscles. So sleep is the potential. And sleep is building you up for the action for the next day. So over a period of time, what has happened is he has cut down on yin. Too much excessive yang. Yes, but where is yang coming from? It is coming from the yin. So he had a huge amount of storage that he was using over a period of years. He used it. It went on depleting. One day it depleted, it said, nothing doing, I can't do anything more. No yin left, he's gone. So doesn't matter how much yang you do, You got to have yin in balance.
Sleep also is very, very much
yes.
Role
yes.
To balance the yin and yang.
Yes. Even now, I will go to the next stage. I was to take this next lecture, but I can take it this time. Now, even yin, the sleep, can I have? Yes. Yes. This is a diagram that you have seen. This is okay. You can take it as yin and yang. Now, in the yin, there we have seen yang, but in that yang, again there is yin. It is telescopic. So now, we take it as sleep. Sleep is yin. Yeah, but in that sleep, there is again yang sleep and yin sleep. Yes. So the yang, the REM sleep is a yang sleep.
Correct.
That is the one that is building us, that is doing the exchange. And when we are tired, what we are having is the yin sleep. So that also we require, both of these. So here also in yang, there is yin.
But they say in REM that is because of assimilation of what is happening.
Yes.
That goes on, means correcting your brain.
Yes, your brain is taking action,
action
to throw it out.
Right.
Action is yang.
It means there is in female, there is male. In
yeah,
male, there is female.
Right. Ardha Nari Nateshwar, that is the concept of us. Yes. Can we reduce the AC a little? Action. Whatever action you are taking, action is yang. Yeah? But in action also, there is yin. Yang and yin. Yes. Like for example, when the driver is driving from Bombay to Goa, if he is driving on a 4-lane highway, there is more of yin. He is hardly doing anything. He is looking there and that's it. And more the automation, more the yin.
Yes.
So passiveness is yin.
Yin. And activeness is yang. And in passiveness, there is activeness. And in activeness, there is passiveness. Further. So the concept is three-dimensional, it is telescopic. So even in case of, for example, you will see that so many people today, we keep on saying that the people who are doing physical work, they should not be having these problems because they are doing a lot of yang work. But today you will go and see that the vegetable vendor is not having good health. The fish owner is not having good health. Because they are not doing the full activity. The fish women that we see today are going to Bhau Ka Dhakka and just buying. They are just traders. And the only physical work they are doing is cutting up the fish. They are not doing anything else. They are not the fisherwomen of earlier days who would go to the near to the sea or keep on stitching the net and so on. Or the trader that we see, for example, the coconut vendor, he is getting the coconuts ready-made and then cutting and giving to you.
Earlier they used to clean
and earlier he would also climb up the tree, get it down from there. So he would do the complete activity. Today what is happening, he is only doing out of that the yin activity. What is more difficult? Climbing up the tree and taking coconut down or cutting a coconut and opening it and giving it to you. So in that action also there is yang. And there is yin. So what happens is when there is too much of yin, again the action is of the yang is reduced. The quality of yang is reduced. Okay. So this is the way it happens. So not only you should have yang, you should also have balanced yang. In that also you should not have excess. You should have combination of this. So just because I am sleeping for 8 days, 8 nights, 8 hours a night. Does not mean that the sleep is okay. We'll feel fresh when the sleep is balanced. If the sleep is not balanced, we'll not feel nice. We cannot say that I am having so much of protein every day. No. If only if the diet is balanced, then the body will feel nice. If the diet is not balanced, it will still not feel nice. Okay. So that was what yin and yang was about. This was the second part. This is what you should be using it in your day-to-day life to analyze or synthesize whatever activities you are doing vis-a-vis the passive parts that you are going into. And now we'll go into the last part of this seminar. The last part will be giving you some hints. Generally, whenever I come, I give some hints which you can use in day-to-day matters, so that you can feel on day-to-day utility of these concepts. Otherwise, these concepts will not be used. So, what is that concept? Is a concept of ear reading.
Concept of
ear reading.
Oh, achha, ear.
Ear. Yes, ears. The whole of our body, the concept is in every organ of our body, the whole body is reflected.
Body?
Is reflected. We had seen it last time when we saw this picture of the face. We had seen this. How on face, full body is reflected. So in the same way, what is done on the face can also be done on the ear. Yes. So, how it can be done is this. This shows that, for example, appendix is here, pancreas is here, central rim is here, brain stem is here, cheek is here, temple is here, forehead is here. So, for example, if you are having headache at any point of time in this area of the head, all that you need to do is press your earlobes.
Like a baby in a mother womb.
Yes. Okay. Or for that matter, if you are having if you are walked along a lot and you are having pain in the cramps or pain in the thighs, then what you should be doing is the upper part of the lip, ears. If you have been sitting for a long time and your back is aching, this vertical part, massage it.
Spinal cord.
Yes. Or you can just tweak your ears. Even now, when you just do this, you will feel a lot of energy coming out. You will feel hotter.
Even if you do massage, you feel hotter.
Yes. Yes. Whenever you feel, when you do ear massage, you will feel hotter. And ears are the first part to go cold, and they are the first parts to become hot. And to remember this is, as he said, it is so easy.
Like
you can just remember this figure.
Behind a mother womb.
Yes. Yes.
Baby in a mother womb.
So now, headache, this side. Earache, this side. Legs, on this side. Many people will be having burning sensation in their soles at night. What they should do is they should apply oil here. Apply oil here, same thing goes to the feet. Or even massage this part with little bit oil on your fingers, you will feel better. When you are sitting, you are having cramps in your calf, again slightly, the point is slightly here. Yeah? Stomach ache is this. All that you need to do for stomach ache is put your fingers in your ear. So this is something that you can use in day-to-day life immediately, very easy to remember, even in fact easier than the face reading part. Yes. So this gives you instant relief. I am not saying that this replaces your doctor at any point of time. It doesn't. But
it's a remote point of the body.
Yes, yes.
A remote point of the body in our
right. And at the same time it gives you immediate relief. Yes. In times of cold, in times of heat. Yes. On the other side, when you are feeling hot, all you need to do is wash your hands, put on your ear. Okay? Or rub this part. This is the nerve which takes the heat with cold water, if possible. You will immediately start feeling cold. Okay? So this was the sweet dish of today's lecture. This is something that you can immediately utilize in your life, in day-to-day life. Okay?
Nahi,
don't think about that. Sochne ka nahi. Pura massage karne ka, itna sa to hai.
Pura karke, aisa kichho
thoda. Yes. Because the more complicated, that's why I showed you the other figure.
Yeah.
This figure. For a practitioner, this is necessary. But it is so detailed that you start doing studying it, you might spend 1 month on just studying it. By the time you will lose your yang to do something.
That is good for acupuncturist or
yes, yes. So the demonstration I was giving was again of yin and yang. What the students require, what we require today is something that I can use today. Something that I can use tomorrow, something I can use in another month's time. But if you give me a lot of food today, then it is not going to utilize at all. Because it is too much yang. Okay, that much effort I don't want to do. But if you give me capsules, one capsule today, two capsules tomorrow, two capsules day after tomorrow, then it is likely that I might take some of those capsules. So this is another way of utilizing yin and yang in your life. Another concept, last concept of today, is yin and yang also gives the like and dislike. So if you are going to do anything,
that means that is why they say personality.
Personality. Yes, yes, yes. So what you like, you are going to do first. What you dislike, you are going to do later. So if you want to give some work to somebody, give some work that he likes, give some work that he dislikes. If you keep a balance between the two, he is going to like working with you.
Continue doing the same work, but you get bored.
Yes, too much of yang.
And work is also done.
No and yin work, available.
And work is also done because yes. Dislike also has to be done.
True, 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 right. So many people get tired in their work because there is too much of yang and no yin is getting built up. That kind of situation. And the other way around. So if you have a balance between like and dislike, you like this, you do this. But along with that, you do that also. Then he will do that also to some extent.
Complete package.
Yes. That is the idea of complete package, yin and yang together. Okay. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much.